All right, without further ado, this is Jana Jae and friends. Make them welcome. You're going to hear a little Under the Double Eagle by Mr. Patrick.
What do you think of him on guitar? I'll tell you, he can play anything, and we can play all night. We're not going to, but sometimes come to one of our shows. And Pat Savage on guitar, right over here on keyboard, we have Spencer Sutton, one of the Tulsa Playboys. Am I shouting at you? Am I pretty loud? If it's okay. And then back here, Jack, wave your hand. Jack Boydstun on bass. He has been my guitarist for like 15 or 20 or 25 or I don't know. He knows the number of years, and he's battling MS, but I had to have him here. So he's playing bass tonight. And now we have Barry Patton. I mean, he's so much fun. So we're going to put everybody to work on a little bit of Old Joe Clark. Thank you. Underwood came all the way from Arkansas, and his assistants Fred and Dave, and they really have been doing a great job with all the changes and everything. We appreciate you guys, and we appreciate the shade. Here's the Blue Valley Waltz. Unison with me, right? That doesn't happen a lot that the guitarist can play this, but he can do it. Oh, you know, we haven't done a show for 6 months. This is a rehearsal for you guys. But we're loving it.
This is one of the first tunes that I got to play with Jana on Nashville Now back in the 90s.
Yeah. John, Ralph Emery about kept him in there. Nashville, too. I had to pull him away.
And what's the new text coming in back in Oklahoma out of this state there?
And we get to Corner Berry. Where's Rainy? His cute wife right down here with Dylan, your little doggy, Berry, we're doing this one for you, too. This is a real unusual one. It's all the way from Brazil. And it's got a big, long name, really, a long title, but we just call it the Brazilian.
Thank you.
guess for Bob Wills, we're just going to do a little bit of Bob Wills, starting with the Faded Love that my granddaddy taught me all by myself on the porch.
Thank you.
the world's championship. World champion, not just national championship, a play in the bones. And he went over to Ireland to the world championship bones. Why don't you tell him a little bit about that?
Well, thank you, Jana. Well, I got, you know, bone playing around these parts. How many of you ever heard a guy really play the bones? I mean, there was Cecil Hyatt, Oklahoma Bones. He taught me how years ago. And my lovely wife, she was saying, you know, you got an invitation to go over and play for the world championship in Ireland. We got an invitation. We better go. And I went there to support the USA. And what was involved, there wasn't a lot of money involved with this competition, but there was probably 50 to 80 bone players over there. And you jam in these pubs for 2 days prior to that. It's a five-day festival. The last day is the world champion bone contest, and they come from all over, Canada, Europe, everywhere. And they watch you play. And so a lot of people started dropping out before the contest got on there because they watched you play. So they wasn't going to pay the 30 pounds or whatever we were. So you know what happened. So there I was getting a big old trophy of a Waterford crystal, and I thought, my wife said, you're going home, you're going to practice, and you're going to win that Waterford crystal. And sure enough, I didn't think I could do it, but I went over there and I won it for the USA and for all of us and brought it back. And yes, red, white, and blue. But anyway, we did it. We had a large time, got to meet a lot of cool people, and the contest was great. And now the rest is history.
And now he is the world champion. The national champion in the world. So he told me what he won on was this little John Ryan's book, and he just taught it to me. I've heard it a lot of times, but anyway. And then we're going to go into, we'll do a little Celtic medley for Barry's championship. Robin Coleman, my granddaughter, is going to help me on the Rights of Man and Swallowtail Jig, because it's so nice with a twin fiddle. Get right in there to my book. Triplets that da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Just do that by yourself. I want to see if your fingers leave your hand.
Oh, yeah, listen to me.
He makes it look so easy. It ain't that easy.
Nothing up my sleeves, that's why I wore short sleeves tonight.
Okay, we're going to do something kind of different now. We're going to do a little kind of a jazz number, and this is called How High the Moon. Wes Paul and Mary Ford did this, and then Charlie Parker turned it into ornithology. So we're going to do both. Vocal too for some of you gals out there. Okay, we're going to hit a little bluegrass tune for Barry to show off again. We've never done this one, Spencer. Hang on there. This is called the Granny White Special. Where's Granny White out there? I saw all we. She's a granny. I'm a granny. How many grannies do we have out there? We have a whole bunch of them. And how about grandpas? Oh, they're relaxed. Okay. Real fast. One, two, three. Does not like the sunshine. We're going to skip that one and tell you goodbye. I haven't heard this tune all day. It's one of my favorites. It's from the Ken Burns documentary, and it's a beautiful haunting melody, very simple. I'm going to dedicate it to all the veterans out there, all the folks who have served, anybody who's suffered from COVID, someone special in your life, and this is the Ashokan Farewell. Secondhand. Barry and I are going to do this.
I think when I was born, I was secondhand.
Here's Barry and the guys. They're so good. We'll get it in a minute, I promise. And Amy, oh, you got it? Okay, she's got the time to start when I start the fast notes and you stop at the high note. Okay. One, two, three, four. drums, Spencer Sutton, Jack Boydstun, Pat Savage. We thank you all so much.
Get a big hand for Miss Jana Jae.